I'm Ben, and this is Hyperfine, resources and tutorials for architects by architects. Today I'm going to share how to create some Revit people components. We're going to start in Illustrator and end with a Revit silhouette person you can use in any project. The trick here is that they will be Revit detail components. I like adding people to my Revit sections and elevations with detail components for a few reasons. You can quickly add these silhouette people to any section or elevation without worrying about them showing up in another view. You can easily change the color, and you can make any outline you want. Clients with dogs, for example, love it when you put a dog in their drawings, you know, their schematic drawings. I've made a couple of these Revit people components that you can download for free on hyperfinearchitecture.com. Check out the free resources page. But if you want to learn how to make your own, keep watching. I'll show you exactly how it's done, and I'll show you how to add a Revit parameter in the family so you can have multiple silhouette people in one family. Let's get started. Here we are in Illustrator, and you see I've got this silhouette people vector file open. If you can, you want to start with some vector images because you can more or less trace over those lines once you get into Revit. You can find tons of silhouette people online. Just make sure you have permission to use the image. I found these at stock.adobe.com. And all we're going to do is go up to File, Export, Export As. I'll give it a name. Export as a DWG, and we will accept the defaults. And that's it for Illustrator. I'll pick this back up when we get into Revit. Okay, we're in Revit. We're going to go to New Family, and we're going to choose Detail Item. So this will be the template that we base our new family off of. So the blank family template has opened up, and the first thing we're going to do before we do anything fun is do a save as, because we don't want to overwrite anything in this Revit default one. You just want this to say blank forever so you can always reuse it. So the first thing you got to do is do a save as. All right, now we can get to work on the Insert tab, go to Import CAD, and choose the DWG that we exported from Illustrator. And it gives us some warnings, that's fine. Here you see our drawing has come into the family. So the DWG is in our project now. We want to move it so that this man is centered in the family. So if we select the entire DWG, we'll unpin it, and now we can just use our move command to start right around by his foot and put him right up near the center. And this doesn't have to be perfect, but you want to get it close. Now we want to see what size this is, because a lot of times it's not going to come in correct, and all I'm going to do is I'm going to do a line just to sort of get a rough measurement real quick. And you see it's 39 feet tall. So we want to scale this entire thing so that it's more an accurate size. So if I select the entire DWG, I'll do RE to scale. I'll start at this point. I'll select just about the top of his head, and I'll drag down, and I want him to be 6 feet, so I'm just going to type in a 6, enter. Now these people are more of a human scale. He's about 6 feet, the women are slightly shorter. Alright, so next we're going to start tracing over the outline of this man with the filled region to create our detail component. The first thing we're going to do is select the DWG, and we're going to do a full explode so that we can have access to those vector lines in there. And it might give you an error, is basically saying some lines are too short. Just accept whatever it is, delete any elements, and basically there's some really small lines in here that it are too small for it to draw, and we'll fix that in a little bit. So now you can see I've got this outline figure of this man, and I can actually select all these lines. So I'm going to do RF, that's a custom shortcut to create a filled region. You can learn more about that on my shortcuts video, or download those for free on the resources page. And I'm just going to use the line picker tool, and I'm gonna start picking the lines. And I'm hitting tab to try to get a string of lines. And I'm gonna speed up the video now as I go through this, and I'll come back to it when I've got through the entire person. Okay, I finished tracing over the entire guy, and all I have to do to end this filled region is hit the green button. And you see I get a ton of errors. And basically, just read down here, the lines must be in closed loops. Basically saying I missed some, or some lines are too small to draw. So what you're going to have to do is zoom in to where those errors are. You can see that line is not closed. If the line picker tool doesn't want to draw it, In that case, it did. Sometimes you just have to drag one on top of the other and basically just go through until you fix all those little errors. So I'm gonna pause the video again and I'll come back in when this is complete. Okay, so I've patched all the holes, and the only other thing to notice is that down here I flattened his feet out so that whenever view he's in, he's gonna stand perfectly flat on the floor. And it might look a little bit weird, but it really doesn't matter in the grand scheme of things. With this being a silhouette person, it's not gonna look bad with their feet kind of flattened out like that. So all I'm gonna do is hit OK, and it makes the fill pattern. And by default, it set it up to this concrete block, so we'll see what else they have in here. Solid fill black, so we can set them to default to be black, and we'll go with that one. That'll be fine. So the next thing I'm going to do is create the woman. So I'm going to select this fill region. I'll hit CS to create similar, and then I'll continue this process with this woman. So I will pause the video and I'll come back when I have completed her. Okay, so I finished the woman. She was the concrete style also. I just switched her over to the same black outline. So I'm going to do a couple things to set this file up before we insert it into our project. First, I'm going to select the man and the woman. I'm just going to do HH to temporarily hide them. And if I select all these outlines we don't need anymore, I'm just going to delete them to make sure our file stays clean. Then I can do HR to reset that temporary hide. All right, so now what we want to do is set up a parameter so that we can choose to show either the man or the woman only using one family. So what I'm going to do is select the man, and if we go to visible and check this box right here, we can add a parameter, and we're just going to call this one man, and we're going to make it a type, and automatically it's a yes no, which just means yes no on or off, and we'll hit OK. And we'll hit OK. We'll do the same thing for the woman. We'll select the woman, hit this checkbox right here, add a parameter, call it woman, and it'll be a type also, and we'll say OK. Okay. So now if we come into our properties, or our properties menu, you can see we've got these parameters right here, and they're both checked on. So what we're gonna do is make a new family type, and we'll call this family type man. And since it's the man, we're going to say the man is on, the woman is off. And now we'll do the exact same thing for the woman. We'll say woman, the man will be off, the woman will be on, and we'll hit OK. Now what we want to do is move her over to the center as well. So I'm going to select her, hit MV, and just more or less move her into the center. I can shift the man over a little bit also. And that's it. This family is complete. It's ready to be loaded into our project. All right, to load this into our project, all we're going to do is, while the video is paused, I open up my project, and we're just going to click Load Into Project. And it's the only one I have open, so it's going to load it in here. And you can see automatically it's going to start letting me place one. So I'll place the man, and there he is. If I escape a couple times, it closes the command. If it didn't automatically do that, or you want to go add one of these people into a different view, where these things will reside is if you go up under Annotate, Detail Component. It'll be right here in all the detail components you have. So there's the man. Now I'll choose to place the woman. And there she is. A custom Revit Silhouette Detail Component People Family that you can use in any project right now. And that's the tutorial. Thanks for watching. Remember, you can download these for free along with a lot of other Revit and ARE and design resources over at hyperfinearchitecture.com. If you like this video, please hit like. If you want to stay up to date as I create more tutorials, please subscribe. And feel free to leave a comment if you have a request for a future video. Thank you.